too much buffers. There's a lot of top players. So let's jump right into this match. Salem versus Vash. Like you said, Little Mac is such a scary opponent to fight against, right? Because he just has so much stage control as long as you just don't get knocked off.
Yeah. Does pretty decent here, believe it or not, man. You know, he has the tools to kind of apply some pressure from up underneath these taxi platforms. Okay, good stuff. Throwing out the Jolt Haymaker because he has to get back as quickly as possible. But that's going to... Oh, wait. He saved this jump. Oh, it matters not at this point. You're not an air fighter, baby.
Dude, as a Little Mac, you have to save your jump. And he's doing a very good job of just, you know, keeping that in tow. But Salem, you know, the EVO 2017 champion, man, he knows what he's doing, especially against the second he gets that first hit against Mac, he's just going to push him off stage, not allow him to get back every single time.
You know, and this is a really scary position to be in. Not only are you going against a character that's very well equipped to take you off stage, but now Salem has the lead. He can very much get into camp mode where he just kind of stays on those platforms, and it can really make it that much harder for Vash to find any access points to him. Okay, tried to go for a pivot dash attack. There's the up tilt. Now I heard that the up tilt's a really good tool at not only dominating space, but leading into other combos.
Yeah, it's the up tilt and down tilt. Both of them are very good use. Can't we just be pushing buttons against Bayonetta? Tries to go for a heavy read. Nice timing from Salem just to avoid that with a nice roll. Goes for the slip counter out of the downer.
The slipperiest of the counters, man. Gets out of harm's way as quickly as possible, but it seems to matter not at this point. Uh-oh. Okay, try to go for the Superman up special.
And Vash did a good job of just avoiding that second hit of that witch twist, man. If you get hit by the second one, you're done for. Oh, speaking of done for, that witch time. He's getting knocked off. He still has his double jump. Tries to go for offstage, and it is over. Bayonetta just has so much coverage offstage that you can just chill below the Little Mac, go for the witch twist, knock him off, get back to the stage. Another day in the park for Salem.
That ain't even right, man. Obviously, Smash 4, it's a game of tier lists, but we don't really, you know, when it comes to talking about where characters and where players are, I know, like, the player tier list and then the character tier list, two very different lists, but I got to know about Bayonetta and Little Mac. I want to know what the matchup ratio is. I know the Macs might feel one way. I've heard one story from the Bayonettas, but after watching that, it's looking like 80-20 or something crazy like that, Austin.
I mean, it definitely doesn't look too much in Little Mac's favor, but you do have to remind yourself that Salem is like the second best player currently in the world, according to the PGR. Second.
You know, and there has been Macs that have beaten Bayos in the past. I'm thinking back to a few events like around the CEO time. I think Captain Zach had a Little Mac issue for a while. So it's very doable, but it's very, very hard. But let's see what we get here into the next game. I think I seen Witch Time activated right there. So that was pretty solid read. I think just a little late on the execution. It looked like he was trying to read out Bash's forward tilt, or up tilt, excuse me.
Yeah, Salem's doing a fantastic job of just holding on to his shield, waits for Vash to commit to an option and to go for the shield. That was just a terrible spot for Vash to get caught off the platform.
Oh, my goodness.
Anytime Little Mac is sent off stage, Salem would just, he's gone.
That was just messed up. You know, honestly, that was just messed up. You know, such a very strong start, but that platform really, really screwed him up. Okay, good stuff. They're using the super armor there on those force masters. I sometimes forget Little Mac even has that. Boom, there's the back throw.
There we go, nice catch with that down smash. Covers multiple options. Great option select. Could have caught the normal one or the roll to the right. Gets the power shield, sends him up flying. Gonna try to DI away from the second witch twist. Good stuff. Opts to just go for the back air instead.
Yeah, wants to play it safe, man. We also have to stay mindful of Little Mac's KO meter. You know, that's obviously the ultimate turnaround factor. Down tilt, up special. He's back in the game.
Yeah, Vash is awake, and he almost has his KO meter on deck. He manages to get that. One down tilt can lead into a KO meter.
Okay.
KO punch.
Obviously has some ground to make up here, but obviously with the fact that the matter that he has the KO punch almost online here, he can really push this into a game at number three. But it's really going to come down to how well he can get in and stay in. Boom, there's another witch switch. Puts him far away. Oh, no. Facing the wrong way. Not a good spot to be in. There's a Jolt Haymaker. Saves his jump. Goes high that time. Gets a second chance at life.
But unfortunately for him, he lost the KO punch because he took too much damage. He's off stage again. This is looking very sad for Vash. Gets off to the platform. Nice coverage from Salem. Not letting him get back with the bullets.
Okay. Gets him a pass back onto the stage there. Good stuff. Gets the tech in. Wow. What a read. Austin LaVista.
What else can you say, man? But nice back air.
I was actually expecting a Moana reference. You said, what else can I say? I wanted to say you're welcome. But anyway, we're moving. Let's talk about it, though, Austin, man.